Hello everyone, welcome to my presentation. I'm Sachin Ashok, a first-year graduate student at UIUC. Today in my presentation, I hope to highlight the emergence of service meshes as a new layer in the networking stack and lay out some challenges and research opportunities that they bring. This work is in collaboration with my advisors at UIUC, Brighton Godfrey and Radhika Mittal. Let's start with a simple observation of how software has evolved. Software used to exist like this monolith where different components talk to each other through function calls. Today, for reasons like better scalability and easier deployment, they're slowly moving to a microservice style architecture where different modular pieces of the system software are developed independently and talk to each other not through function calls, but through network calls. This means that network communication has now become quite intrinsic to an application's functioning. Here's a visualization of Netflix, which is one such large-scale production microservice. What you notice is that it's a multi-hop DAG with many, many stages. Inevitably, with many such services talking to each other, developers end up spending a lot of time writing communication logic like how to do name resolution or load balancing, while what they really want to be doing is just focusing on the application's business logic. So in order to factor out this common communication functionality that all these services need, service meshes have recently emerged. Service meshes take this existing microservice and convert it into this architecture where all the communication functionality has been factored out and placed within a separate process called a sidecar. As you can see in this figure, every microservice instance is now paired up with a sidecar which performs all inbound and outbound network communication. This sidecar, the red box, routes traffic at the granularity of a HTTP level request. As you can see in this animation, when an external HTTP request reaches the sidecar, it hands it over to its microservice which processes it and may issue many new internal requests to service it. This is the general communication pattern. It's important to highlight that there are three distinct transport connections in an end-to-end path, as you can see in the figure. The first is between the source application and the sidecar. The second is between the two sidecars, and the third is between the destination sidecar and the application. The sidecar can provide a rich set of features within the second transport connection without modifying the applications or their transport connections. Some of these features are listed here. For example, the sidecar can do load balancing between multiple replicas of a service. The sidecar can also do name resolution for services so that the app developer doesn't have to keep track of the exact IP address and, in fact, does not even need to know which replica of a service the app is even talking to. These are just some examples of features these sidecars provide. But the sidecars only form the service mesh's data plane. The service mesh also has a control plane which can control these sidecars as a whole. The control plane offers users a global view and allows them to specify mesh-wide policies as well as configure the data plane, while the data plane is responsible for executing local functions. Now with a better understanding of service meshes, let's move on to what implications these hold for networking research. Our paper at a high level first makes the argument that it's quite useful to think of service meshes as a new layer in the network stack which sits between the app and the transport. Fundamentally, there are two questions. One, how is it a layer? It's a layer because it abstracts the lower layer functionality from the application. For example, the app is unaware of which exact replica of a service it is talking to because the service mesh abstracts out that detail. Additionally, all inbound and outbound app traffic goes through the service mesh via the sidecar, which is consistent with how layering works. Now, coming on to why that is even a useful abstraction, we believe that viewing service meshes as a layer helps highlight them as a convenient location to observe and enhance cross-layer communication. And additionally, service meshes can be application agnostic and expose standard APIs which make any optimizations available to all apps running on top of it. Our view of the network stack deviates from the conventional OSI 7-layer model, but network layering has evolved in the real internet over the past many years, and this is our evolved view of the cloud-native network stack. When viewing the service mesh as a distinct layer in the stack, several opportunities naturally present themselves. The first is to do with the enhanced visibility that they offer. To illustrate, let me zoom into one application sidecar pair. So far, our visibility and reach as networking researchers has been restricted to the network layer IP packet. With the addition of service meshes, we can now look into each HTTP request that an app sends and receives. This gives us an enhanced visibility and allows us to look into the internal operations of an application and have better context of the overall API call tree. This enhanced visibility can be used for monitoring, troubleshooting, and root cause analysis. Now, going beyond passive monitoring and visibility, we identify how service meshes explicitly gain a better knowledge of the application's needs. Dozens of research proposals for various optimizations like priority-aware flow scheduling have been proposed in the past, which all assume a knowledge of application specifics like the flow priority. With an explicit service mesh API, applications can now directly signal preferences. For example, knowledge of flow priority or sizes could be passed on to the sidecar, thereby making it available to the lower layers and help make such research proposals more practical in reality. The third opportunity we identify is that service meshes offer easier evolvability of network functionality compared to other layers. Adding and modifying functionality in a deployable way is a recurring difficulty. Service meshes provide a convenient platform to easily deploy new functionalities, and this is enabled by two facts. One is that they run in user space and therefore can be more easily modified as compared to changes to the physical network. Two, service mesh APIs are easily extensible with optional parameters. They avoid the careful standardization processes at lower layers, which usually makes extensions harder. For example, as mentioned by the Snicket paper earlier in the session, WebAssembly extensions can be used directly to extend the sidecars. This shows a lot of promise for evolvability. Let's think of custom transport protocols as another example. The sidecar here could be programmed to easily change the congestion control algorithm between the two sidecars from BBR to COPA to PCC, all the while the application itself is unmodified and completely unaware. Finally, we also identify an opportunity to coordinate explicitly with the lower layers. Just as service meshes can benefit from knowledge of application needs, the app itself can benefit from knowledge of the lower layers. For example, an SDN controller could provide explicit hints to the sidecar regarding the level of congestion. As you can see in this animation, as congestion increases, the SDN controller notifies the service mesh, and the service mesh uses that information to reroute its traffic. We now showcase a study which leverages several of these opportunities. Consider for a moment an eLibrary microservice as shown here. This application services two different kinds of workloads, latency-sensitive and non-latency-sensitive. Latency-sensitive traffic, for example, may include users traversing a website or streaming media. Non-latency-sensitive traffic, on the other hand, include background jobs like batch analytics or log processing. The goal of our prototype is quite simple. It aims to provide request-level prioritization for latency-sensitive requests throughout this microservice application, which serves a mix of workloads. The aim here is to implement this prioritization by leveraging the capability of the sidecar to do cross-layer coordination with very minimal coupling with the application. Our design involves three components. First, we classify an application's performance objectives right at the ingress. For prioritization, this means that the front-end application tags requests as either high or low priority. We use custom HTTP headers to pass this priority information to the sidecar. Next, to carry out these performance objectives, that is, the priorities through the entire system, every sidecar in turn copies priority bits of its incoming requests onto any outgoing requests it spawns. And finally, to implement cross-layer prioritization functionality through the layers of the sidecar, many options are now available. For example, one could prioritize requests at the message queue level, or at the transport level, we can open multiple parallel transport connections running different protocols and choose the right connection based on the QS of the request. Additionally, we could also do prioritization at the packet level at lower layers like the kernel. For the purpose of illustrating our main points, in our prototype, we do kernel prioritization of the sidecar for latency-sensitive packets. Now, to evaluate our prototype implementation, we use the following setup. We use workload generators to hit the API gateway with both kinds of workloads. And in order to create network contention, we set up a bottleneck of 1 Gbps as shown by the red circle. More details are in the paper. On running the system and optimization, we get the following results. The x-axis shows increasing RPS rates and the y-axis shows the corresponding end-to-end latency. In red is the performance of the latency-sensitive workload without any optimization, and in blue is the performance with the optimization. As you can see, as the RPS values increase, latency goes up, but in the optimized case, we get around 1.5 to 2x improvement, both for the 50th and the 99th percentile latency. Therefore, as our cross-layer optimization enabled by service mesh reduces latency for high priority traffic. So what does this prototype exactly demonstrate? First, it shows that we can use knowledge of application needs for various optimizations across a microservice using tracing. In this case, we trace the priority of requests throughout the microservice. It also shows that we can easily evolve the sidecar and deploy many optimization schemes without modifying the app. And finally, it shows how by abstracting the details from the application layer, these optimizations are made available to any app that runs on top of the service mesh layer. This shows that service meshes can be used effectively for cross-layer solutions. Before concluding, I will briefly talk about challenges and future directions. One obvious challenge is the added latency caused due to the sidecars. Here, exploring kernel bypass techniques to improve performance is a possible future direction. Dagger is a recent paper which takes initial steps in this direction. Additionally, different network layers may provide similar functionality and hence conflict with each other. For example, app layer load balancing might conflict with network layer load balancing. So how does one define the scope of responsibilities? A HotNets paper from last year highlights this problem. Finally, the prototype described here is quite basic. One obvious future direction is to extend the cross-layer prioritization to also include compute and storage. Now to finally summarize, in this talk, we have identified service meshes as a new emerging layer in the cloud networking stack. We have identified plenty of resource opportunities which leverage the enhanced visibility, the knowledge of application needs, the evolvability of the infrastructure, and the opportunity to do cross-layer coordination. And finally, we present a prototype which leverages several of the above opportunities to achieve fine-grained cross-layer prioritization. With that, now I finish my talk, and I hope I've been able to highlight service meshes as well as the abundant opportunities they hold for networking research. Thank you.